Hi, everyone. Welcome to the Azure Security Expert Series Deep Dive Session. My name is Albert Chu. I'm a Senior Product Manager in the Azure Marketing Team. And today we are joined by Suren Jamiana. She's a Program Manager with the Azure Firewall Team. This session will be focusing on protecting your critical Azure resources with Azure Firewall. Over to you, Suren.
Thanks, Albert. Hi, everyone. My name is Suren, and I'm so excited to share with you today on how you can protect your resources with Azure Firewall. And so today I'm going to start with some trends that we're seeing and then introduce you to what Azure Firewall is and then how it meets those trends and needs. Next, I'll share about how the service prioritizes your organization's security needs and then share how you can grow and scale your network security with Azure Firewall Manager and Firewall Policy. So we know that organizations are undergoing a massive digital transformation to the cloud. Not only are apps moving to the cloud, but apps and workloads within the cloud are growing at a rapid pace. And so there's a need for a cloud-native network security solution that can help lock down your applications and workloads and filter based off of your traffic patterns that you are seeing in your network. Azure Firewall is a cloud-native firewall as a service. And so what this means is instead of traditionally standing up VMs on your own and having to maintain them regularly, all you have to do with Azure Firewall is deploy to the cloud, and you can almost take a hands-off approach with it in terms of the behind-the-scenes management. And so how I would like to think about Azure Firewall when you protect your resources is that it's a way to centrally govern all of your traffic flows, and mainly based off of the network, NAT, and application traffic filtering capability. Azure Firewall is also integrated with Microsoft's threat intelligence feed so that it can block known malicious IP addresses and FQDNs attempting to come into your network. Next, if you want to place your firewall in your Azure environment, you can protect your virtual network by placing it between the internet. You can place your Azure firewall going spoke to spoke. And then you can also place your firewall to filter traffic coming from your on-prem environment to the cloud. And lastly, you can view all the traffic that is going through your firewall with our centralized logging capabilities, and then you can save and view them at a later time. I want to share with you the modern cloud approach with Azure Firewall. So Azure Firewall has full built-in high availability and auto scalability. What this means is that in case of anything happens to a firewall, if one instance or region goes down, there will always be a backup with zero downtime. And Azure Firewall can scale with your applications and your workloads for up to 30 Gbps based on CPU and throughput. And when you deploy an Azure Firewall, it'll be deployed into an availability zone or multiple availability zones in that case, guaranteeing up to a 99.99% guarantee that your Azure Firewall will always be available. And you can also scale the firewall by increasing the number of public IP addresses. And this is particularly useful for your SourceNAT and DNAT translation traffic. In addition, I want to highlight the ability with Azure Firewall to have integration with Azure, the Azure environment. And so Azure Firewall is best for Azure because you can architect seamlessly with other Azure components in our ecosystem. And specifically with Azure Firewall, you can utilize features like FQDN tags and service tags so that you can filter Microsoft outbound traffic, such as app services environments or to your Windows virtual desktop deployments. And lastly, you can utilize Azure Firewall with other services like Azure DNS and Azure Sentinel and many more. We want to prioritize your organization's security needs by our constant and continuous innovation and growth with our new features. So we've recently added native force tunneling support so that if you wanted to stack up an additional firewall to Azure Firewall, we allow that to happen. So that adds some added security benefits. We also added a whole new set of new traffic filtering capabilities. For example, you can now use FQDNs and network rules for all ports and protocols other than HTTPS and MS SQL traffic. IP groups is also a new feature that helps you group multiple IP addresses, and you can give it a friendly name so that you don't have to manually type out every individual IP address in your firewall rules. And today I'm also really excited to share a new feature coming out called Web Categories, and it is now in public preview. And I'll talk more about how to use Web Categories and firewall policy later in our session. And we also recently added DNS features, including custom DNS and DNS proxy. DNS proxy in Azure Firewall will allow Azure Firewall to serve as a proxy for your DNS requests so that you can forward it to your own custom DNS server that you want to use. With DNS proxy, you can also use it very well with private link services. And then also, we're also planning to add threat intelligence capability so that I can block known malicious IPs and FQDNs beforehand so that a VM won't even try to connect to one if it's malicious in the first place. And I actually want to show you a demo on how you can use custom DNS and DNS proxy in our DNS settings. Great. So I shared some highlights with you about Azure Firewall. Now, let's say that your workloads and applications are growing, and you need to find a way to protect your resources at scale. So with growing and scaling your network security, it comes with some enterprise challenges with a complex network architecture and a constantly changing threat environment. You would need complete visibility into the network, a way to enforce policies across not just one firewall, but multiple firewalls. And you also want to focus on having a zero trust security model and have an ability to respond to rapid new internet attacks. And with these challenges, we offered some a way to address these challenges with these solutions. So for example, we want to focus on being able to provide a way to centrally manage your firewalls and your growing network. We wanted to provide a way to simplify rule management across multiple firewalls with firewall policy. And using Azure Firewall Manager that I'll talk more about, you can now secure your network more in a more automated way and rapidly push firewall protection to new threats. So with these problems of growing and scaling at large, we wanted to create a solution for you in our modern cloud approach, and this is through our service called Azure Firewall Manager. And what Azure Firewall Manager is, it's a way to centrally manage and administer rules and protection across multiple firewalls. And we do this through our main vehicle through firewall policy, where you can create almost a copy of a firewall and replicate that copy across multiple firewalls. You can also view all of your firewall instances at the same time in our Azure Firewall Manager portal. And what Azure Firewall Manager supports are two deployment architectures. And so the first deployment architecture is called the Hub Virtual Network. And this is where you can essentially think of it as a home of your firewall, and you can deploy a firewall to a virtual network, a VNet. The second deployment architecture that Azure Firewall Manager supports is the Secured Virtual Hub. And in this scenario, you can automatically deploy an Azure firewall in an Azure Virtual WAN, a wide area network. And this also has added benefits with having third-party security support with Zscaler, Checkpoint, and iBoss. And it also has automated security and routing capabilities. So I want to talk more about how you can empower your growth and your scale of your network security with firewall policy. And so what firewall policy is, it's a way for you to, I almost think of it as kind of a copy of your Azure firewall. And you can use it as a way to apply Azure firewall rules to multiple firewalls at once. And because Azure firewall policy is a top-level resource, it can be applied to different firewalls across Azure regions and subscriptions. Similarly, to Azure Firewall. It has network, NAT, and application traffic filtering, and all the features that you find in a standard or traditional Azure Firewall instance. Azure Firewall Policy also has a hierarchical capability. So you can have the concept of a global and local firewall policy. So let's say that you have a couple regions using this one firewall policy, and one region has something slightly nuanced and you want to add a little bit more granularity. Well, you can create a child policy to address that, the difference in that one particular region that you need to. And lastly, I want to highlight that Azure Firewall Policy is independent of Azure Firewall Manager. So you can create a firewall policy on its own and be able to attach it to a single firewall, or you can also create a firewall policy using Azure Firewall Manager. And we'll be having Azure Firewall Policy as a new way or mechanism to add more features in our future growth of Azure Firewall. So in this demo, I want to show you how you can actually create an Azure Firewall by migrating an existing firewall. So if I go to the Create Experience, I can actually go to my rules and click Import. And what that does is I can select an existing Azure Firewall, import all of the rules that it already had, import all those settings, and that can include the Microsoft Threat Intelligence settings or DNS settings, and basically copy and paste my old traditional firewall, Azure Firewall, into Azure Firewall Policy so that I can abstract it away and apply it to other firewalls. We also have recently added features to Firewall Policy, and this includes that migration experience that I just shared with you so that you can migrate from Azure Firewall Classic to Firewall Policy. We also updated the user interface and added new scenarios like having both standard policy and premium policy that my colleague will share more on our talk later today. And then next, I'm so excited to share you a new feature called Web Categories, and it's now in public preview. And Web Categories is a firewall policy feature for administrators to filter web traffic in the form of categories for user protection. So example categories include social media websites or news sites or gambling sites. And so this allows you to protect your network and your resources also for the end users in your network. And it's particularly useful if you also have a Windows virtual desktop or remote desktop environment. So I'd love to share with you a demo of how to add web categories in your firewall application roles. So here you'll see that you can add web categories as a destination type. And when you select web categories, you'll see a dropdown of all the different web categories that you can select to choose whether to allow or deny into your network. And so in this example, I'm just going to pick an example categories for you to add to your application rules. And lastly, I want to summarize Azure Firewall and the future direction of it. So we've shared with you a few new capabilities of Azure Firewall and how you can grow and scale your firewall using Azure Firewall Manager. We also have a new Azure Firewall Premium that is coming out with a host of new and next generation firewall features. And I want to emphasize that with Azure Firewall, you can grow your workloads and applications rapidly alongside with the growth of Azure.
Thank you, Suren. That is really insightful in how you have, you know, helped our audience understand how to protect all the critical resources in Azure using the Azure Firewall. Now, we do have a couple of questions from the floor. I'd like to share with you, and if you could answer some of these questions. Could you tell us the difference between Azure Firewall and Azure Firewall Manager?
So Azure Firewall is used for network segmentation, application protection, and central logging in Azure. While Azure Firewall Manager provides you one control plane for centralized configuration and management for multiple firewall instances across Azure regions and subscriptions.
Yes, that's great. Yeah. The second question we have from the floor is Azure Firewall integrated with Azure Sentinel?
Yes. So Azure Sentinel has a connector that can ingest or take in Azure Firewall logs, enabling you to view your log data in workbooks, use it to create custom alerts, and you can incorporate it to improve your investigation of your traffic patterns.
And the third question we have is, does Azure Firewall support deep packet inspection?
Yes. So with the public preview of Azure Firewall Premium, the intrusion detection and prevention IDPS functionality will be supported. And so make sure you check out the next deep dive on Azure Firewall Premium.
Thank you, Siren. That's great. Yeah. All right. That's all the time we have today. I'd like to thank Siren again for sharing such, you know, great information about Azure Firewall. This session is, is very informative for any of you who are security practitioners, network administrators who are really looking at how to implement cloud-native firewall and really getting the benefits of, Azure Firewall cloud-native benefits. All right, so thank you for watching, and we'll see you again in other deep dive sessions.